Okay, good morning, class. As we start our lesson today, we are still studying in the book of Ephesians. And this morning, we want to read in chapter 3, starting at verse 11 on through 21. And we're still wanting to continue to pray for all the sick and afflicted, our caregivers, and, you know, all the firefighters and police officers out there and just battling this stuff every day, and, you know, the conflicts that we're all facing, and we'll pray for our leadership, you know, and pray that the Holy Spirit will be in our midst here this morning and open our hearts and minds to the understanding of His Word and what it means to us, you know. And what I want to do is to read over the scripture first, and then come back and read other scriptures and try to bring a more clear, a more complete picture, a vision of what Apostle Paul was telling the people here at Ephesians. Because, you know, if you're like me, sometimes when I read something, I think I know, but then whenever I hear somebody start explaining it to me, you know, well, that wasn't exactly what I thought. But anyway, so let's get started this morning. Open up with prayer and see where the Lord will lead us. And our message here today, dear Heavenly Father, as we come to the throne of grace, we want to thank you for this opportunity to be back in your presence, to read your word and study. And Lord, we just pray to you, Lord, for all the sick and afflicted, those that have lost loved ones, and our caregivers, our officers, and firefighters are all out there working on our behalf. And Lord, we just ask that you strengthen us, dear Lord, to hold on and have trust and faith in you always. Grace, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, so if we start out here at verse 11, read through 21, says, to the intent that now unto the principalities and powers in heavenly places might be known by the church the manifold wisdom of God. Okay, that was number 10. So now we move on to 11. It says, according to the effectual purpose which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him. Wherefore I desire that you faint not at my tribulations for you, which is your glory. For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that we would grant you, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened and with might by his Spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints which is the breadth, the length, the depth, and the height, and to know the love of Christ, which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus, throughout all ages, a world without end. Amen. And dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the reading of your holy word, and that, dear Lord, we pray that this word would be instilled in our hearts and minds, Lord, that it will guide us in the days to come, and that we will serve you more and be better children. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Now, as we start out here in verse 11, he said, according to the purpose, the eternal purpose, which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord. He said it's possible in Christ Jesus, it's possible for all to be, to achieve what he, what Gentiles and the uncircumcision was have, it will be possible to all. Okay? In 1 John 4 and 8, he says this, If a man say, I love God and hate his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother, whom he hath seen, how can he love God, whom he hath seen? You know, and that's the thing. This eternal purpose that is in God and the Lord Jesus Christ toward us, he's trying to make us to understand that our job is to love God and to raise him up. We can't say that, because if we're not, then we don't have the love of the Spirit of God in us. So, you know, so that you're not saved, in other words. You know? And in Revelation 3, or if you are saying that because you're mad at him, you probably need to get on your knees and ask for forgiveness, right? Okay, in Revelation 3 and 20, Jesus says this, Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me. In other words, we're going to have a fellowship on both sides, us with the Lord and the Lord with us. And this door that he says he has open, for you, nobody can close that door. Because God, it is for everyone, that whosoever, like I say, back to John 3:16, that whosoever would believe on him, that, you know, that it's through the Lord. Lord Jesus came, that the world might be saved, through him might be saved, you know, not to condemn the world, okay? I've read the wrong one, no wonder. Okay, back up here, it says, as we read that, I got my notes mixed up here a little bit, so we'll get straightened out here, Joseph. It says, according to the eternal purpose, which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord, okay? You know, he says, God working through Jesus, him being over all things in the church, upon God's calling, all should come to Jesus and repent to receive salvation, because Christ paid the high price for it. Apostle Paul told Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 1, 8, 9, 10, an unchanging purpose. In other words, this is something that's never going to change. Okay? So he says, Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou partakers of the affliction of the gospel according to the power of God, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus before the world began, but is now made manifested by the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and hath brought to life an immortality to life through the gospel. So, according to the word that he has given us through Jesus Christ, and what they are preaching through the apostles as they wrote the letters, what the Spirit was giving them to write was bringing to light this eternal purpose that he had in himself, that through Jesus Christ, this would be made known, that Jesus is the one that we are to come to and repent for the sins, because Jesus paid the price for that sin that we committed. And it is him that has to accept our repentance, right? So, this is God's will. And we, being sinners, need to understand that. And just think about what God did there for us at Calvary when he sent his son to die. In 1 Peter 1, 2, and 3, it says, provided for the sanctification of believers, you know, for those people that already believed in the Lord and everything, it says, provided sanctification, it says, elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, those that knew the orient about God, understood, you know, through sanctification of the Spirit, unto obedience in the sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ, grace unto you and peace be multiplied. So, you know, of all of us that have been saved and are saved and those that will be saved, you know, if you be sanctified by being, having our sins forgiven and the Spirit of the Lord entering in and cleaning us up to be acceptable, having our names written in the Lamb's Book of Life, this is such a wonderful act, to be bestowed upon us by the Lord. Okay, so blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you. Once you receive this, the baptism into the Lord Jesus Christ, and our love, we give him our love, and all this is reserved in heaven. You will receive, because no one can take it away. As Jesus said, I open the door and no one can close it. You know, so that's the thing that we need to understand, how much God loves us. Verse 12, in whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him, having the faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Our access to God through the Lord Jesus Christ, by our faith and trust, that we, having been forgiven of our sins, name written in the Lamb's Book of Life. In other words, this is all part of God's plan, you know, and the Lord's plan, to, once he hits you, to hang on to you. That's the reason God chastises you when you do something wrong if you're one of his children. He wants you back in line. He wants you because he said he came to you with a holy calling because he wanted you to be saved, right? 1 Peter 1, 2, and 3. No, I've never read that. Go back to 12. It says, our access to God through Jesus Christ, by faith and trust, having been forgiven of sins, and name written in the Lamb's Book of Life, Apostle Paul wrote in Hebrews chapter 4, 15 and 16, he says this, for we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities. So no, everything that we feel, the regret, the hurt inside, the feeling down and being oppressed, and worried so much about everything that's going on, he says, cannot be without feeling, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. So, we don't need to be disobedient. We need to be like Christ. Put our trust and faith in him. Take our cares to him. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace and to help in the time of need. And that's the thing. To for what we need in our help, our uplifting, and to ease our minds, we need to get on our knees and go to the Lord in prayer. We need just to want to, God knows what's in your heart. The Lord knows what's in your heart. But to open it up, tell him how you feel, what you're feeling, and then what you feel like you need. Let him do it inside you, that you will know that he is present. Okay, in 2 John 10 and 9, Jesus says this. Says, I am the door. By me, if any man enters in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. We can go in and out. We can dwell amongst our people. We can dwell amongst all. But when we're saved, we will know what we should do and what we shouldn't do. And the thing, he will be our guide. He will be with us always. Romans 5 and 2, Apostle Paul says, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And our hope is in the Lord Jesus Christ. As God resurrected him, when Jesus returns, Jesus is going to resurrect us too. That is our trust and our faith that we have in him, our hope that we should have life everlasting, right? In Revelations 3 and 8, Jesus wrote, what I've written there, I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it, for thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. That's just it. Once we heard of the Lord, the Bible was read to us, we hear of the Lord Jesus Christ, we became more interested in what he was saying, what he did, and the love of God, and we were saved. We did not deny the name. We did not divide the trust of faith and trust in him. And that, that we being small, being weak, being in the flesh, and kept his word, and had not denied. So Jesus knows all this. He knows that. He knows who we are. And that's the way it's written, that he is strengthened on the inner man through the Spirit of God, right?